In the last video, we talked about the build surface. In today's video, we are going to look underneath the build surface. To be precise, today we are not just looking under the build surface, but under the heated bed. Specifically, we are going to look at the calibration springs. By turning the calibration wheels, the calibration springs are compressed. This allows the build surface to be leveled and the height of the first layer to be adjusted. Unfortunately, the quality of the springs on the Ender 3 and similar printers really isn't worth much. They do not hold the heated bed steady in place when moving, and this can then affect the print quality. Also, the height of the first layer can become out of tune. This can be caused, for example, by vibrations during printing, rough handling of the heated bed, or just light contact between the wire harness and the calibration wheel. This is why many users of these printers are switching to alternatives. These come in form of yellow springs or, for example, silicone mounts of various shapes and colors. I have here probably one of the cheapest variants of silicone mounts available. There is also an option in the form of spacers. For now, let's avoid them. Removing the original springs and replacing them with something better is an incredibly easy operation. Just unscrew the calibration wheels under the Y-axis carriage and remove the original springs. Then slide the better springs or silicone mounts onto the screws. If you don't have automatic build surface calibration, you will need to change the position of the Z-axis limit switch. The original springs are a disaster. If you leave the limit switch in its lowest position and compress the springs almost all the way, the nozzle will be very far from the build surface. Note that I use a 4mm thick mirror as the build surface, and yet the nozzle is far away. Yes, I could turn the calibration wheels and bring the build surface closer to the nozzle. But this, with these springs, will greatly reduce the overall stability of the heated bed when moving. Another option is to use a slight modification to allow the limit switch to be lowered. For those who don't want to destroy the original part of the printer, I have added some links to printable limit switch mounts below the video. The yellow springs are significantly better. Again, I started by leaving the limit switch in the lowest position and compressing the springs almost all the way. Notice that, at least in my case, the nozzle is now under the build surface. It has a very simple solution. I will just move the limit switch a little higher. After homing with the springs compressed almost all the way, the nozzle will be slightly above the build surface. However, I have a lot of freedom in releasing them and possibly leveling the build surface. Of course, it's no problem to move the limit switch a little higher. Now is the turn of the silicone mount. Again, I will start with the limit switch in its lowest position. I have compressed the silicone mounts very hard with the calibration wheels, but still, the nozzle is far below the build surface. The limit switch will therefore need to be moved higher, but this time much higher than in the case of the yellow springs. Before I tell you what to install under your heated bed, I should probably show you some fancy charts and fun stuff like that first. To show you any charts at all, I designed this tester. On this tester, I'm going to test the deformation of the springs and the silicone mounts based on the load on them. I printed the parts for this tester from PETG filament from Filament PM. To WOM, many thanks for this filament. I have prepared loads of 1 and 3 kg as weights. By combining them gradually, I will show you the load from 1 to 8 kg. First, I decided to test the original springs. As you can see, this spring is not one of the strongest in the world. All it took was 4 kg, and the spring is no longer a spring. Second, I decided to test the very popular yellow springs. With a load of 7 kg, I am almost at the limit of this spring. The last 8 kg no longer makes any significant difference in the springiness. And last came the silicon mount. The silicon mount is basically a spacer with the ability to deform and fine-tune its length. Every additional kilogram that is added as a weight does not make this silicon mount any problem. The current load is 8 kg and as you can see, the silicon mount has barely deformed and could easily handle a few more kilograms. As you can see, the original springs are the weakest here. The yellow springs have done a hell of a job, but they are just not up to the silicon mounts. That doesn't mean they are bad. The silicon mounts are the absolute winner here. Here they are all on one screen. Here they are in a chart to make this video look more professional. Basically, it doesn't matter if you choose yellow springs or silicon mounts. Both options will significantly increase the stability of your build surface and prevent you from messing up the high of the first layer. But the most important message is to throw away the original springs and never go back to them.